So today we'll discuss a topic, manual muscle testing. So in this topic we'll discuss definition of the MMT, what is MMT, purpose and uses of manual muscle testing, gradings, how you will grade muscle power, principles of MMT, in which condition you should use MMT, in which condition you should not use MMT, what kind of precautions you have to take, limitations of manual muscle testing, and detailed procedures, instrumentations, and factor affecting the muscle strength. So starting with the introduction, manual muscle testing is used to determine the extent and degree of muscular weakness resulting from disease, injury, or disuse. The records obtained from these tests provide a base for planning therapeutic procedures and periodic retest. Muscle testing is an important tool for all members of health team dealing with the physical residuals of disability. So basically, muscle weakness you have after any kind of disease or injury, after that if you feel any kind of problem in moving your muscle joint, basically problem occur in muscle weakness occurs. For recording the strength of the muscle, you use this manual muscle testing. For taking initial readings and taking final readings, how much patient is recovered after your treatment. So this muscle testing is used as a treatment outcome measure, which is used to quantify your muscle strength power. Moving to the next slide, the maximal amount of tension, muscular strength. What is muscular strength? Is maximum amount of tension or force that a muscle or muscle group can voluntarily exert in a maximal effort when type of muscle contraction, limb velocity, and joint angles are specified. So your muscle strength is a group of muscle a voluntary exert in a maximal effort. And muscular endurance is the ability of a muscle or a muscle group to perform a repeated contraction against resistance or maintain an isometric contraction for a period of time. Talking about muscle power, is defined as generate as much as force as fast as possible. Power does require strength and speed to develop force quickly. So power is directly proportional to the strength speed. Now type of muscle work. Isometric contraction, isotonic contraction, concentric contraction, and eccentric contraction. So here you can see that concentric contraction, eccentric contraction, and isometric contraction. Here you produce a movement inward, here you produce a movement outward. We are talking in relation to biceps. Here in isometric contraction, muscle contracts but does not shortens and lengthen. Here we are just holding a weight but not moving your arm inward and outward. So range of muscle work, this is also explained to you: outer range, inner range, and middle range. Here you can see that this is your inner range, this is your mid range, and this is your outer range. In relation to your lower extremity, this is your inner range, this is your middle range, and this is your outer range. Group of muscle action prime movers, agonist and synergist. You know all this. Elbow flexion, biceps is your prime mover. This triceps is your antagonist. If we extend your elbow, the muscles will be change accordingly. There are three type of synergists: neutralizing or counteracting synergist, conjoint synergist, and stabilizing or fixating synergist. So coming to the definition of MMT, it is a procedure for the evaluation of strength individual muscle or muscle group based upon the effective performance of a movement in relation to the force of gravity or manual resistance through the available range of motion. And the MMT is the most vital part of the motor assessment performed in medical examination. Already explained you, we'll discuss one by one. Basic component of motor examination is nutrition or bulk of the muscle. Second one is tone. Third is reflexes. Fourth is range of motion. Fifth is manual muscle testing. And sixth one is functional assessment. Individual versus group muscle test. Muscles with a common action or actions may be tested as a group, or each muscle may be tested individually. For example, flexor carpi ulnaris and flexor carpi muscles may be tested together as a group of wrist flexion, or flexor carpi ulnaris may be tested more specifically in the action of wrist flexion with ulnar deviation. On the other hand, flexor carpi radialis longus and brevis may be tested more specifically in the action of wrist flexion with radial deviation. So here we are talking about, we can test a group of muscle or individually we can test a muscle according to separating their action. So moving to the next slide, purpose and uses of MMT. Manual muscle testing uses and purpose. First is the severity of the problem can be understood. So you can use to know the severity of the problem, and it is a diagnostic tool. We can plan our treatment goals, determine the extent and degree of muscular weakness resulting from the disease or injury. So again, it is using as a, you can use this as a diagnostic tool. Correlating muscle picture within level innervations, myotomes, जिसको you know what is myotome, a specific group of muscle or individual muscle is. Individual muscle is supplied by a particular motor nerve. MMT is an important tool for all the members of rehabilitation team. So each one know about the muscle power and strength of a different group or particular muscle. Prevent deformity by locating problem areas and help and evaluate the effectiveness of treatment to the therapist. Why MMT is performed? Why it is needed? To get some answers such as, is a particular muscle is normal? Is it weak? Is it strong enough? Is it weak on both the side? It is weak only on one side? Is proximal muscles are weaker than the proximal one? Is there any particular pattern of muscle weakness? Moving to the grades of MMT, MRC scale, Oxford scale, Kendall scale and others. We have lots of scale for measuring your muscle power. Medical Research Council scale. This one is your MRC scale, which is having a 6 grades, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 0 is no contraction. When you will ask a patient to produce, we take example of biceps, you ask a patient to produce elbow flexion, he will not be able to produce any movement, any kind of flickering contraction. So if no contraction is seen when you ask a patient, you command a patient to produce elbow flexion, that situation will be considered as a no contraction and you can grade that muscle zero. If patient able to slightly flicker bicep muscle, he will try to perform bicep contraction but no movement, only flickering you can see on the bicep muscle, that will be grade 1. Full range of motion with eliminated gravity. Patient is able to perform a full range of motion but in the gravity eliminated position. You should know what are the gravity eliminated position and how you can position a patient or a joint in gravity eliminated position. So that will be counted as a grade 2. If you want to grade any muscle 3, muscle will able to perform full range of motion against gravity. And grade 4 is full range of motion with against gravity with minimal resistance, and grade 5 is normal full range of motion with against gravity with maximal resistance. Moving to the next slide, Oxford scale is again divided into 5 categories: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No contraction is present, there is a flickering contraction. Second one is full range of motion with gravity counterbalance or eliminated, full range of motion with against gravity, full range of motion with against gravity, added resistance and muscle function normally. This is almost similar to the MRC scale. This is a Oxford scale. Now moving to Kendall scale. Kendall has divided their grades into terms, and this is known as none, trace, poor, fair, good and normal. None is 0, trace is 1, poor is 2, fair is 3, good is 4 and normal is 5. So moving to the plus or minus grades, we have some plus and minus grades also. So manual muscle testing procedures and key to muscle gradings are, hey, you can see that we have no contraction felt in the muscle, 0, 0 and 0, no movement, and we have tendon becomes prominent on feeble contraction felt in the muscle but no visible movement of a part, you can grade as a 1, 1 and trace. So coming to the minus and plus, moves through partial range of motion, movement in horizontal plane moves through a partial range of motion, you can grade it as a 2 minus, moves through complete range of motion 2 to poor. Anti-gravity position moves through partial range of motion, you can grade it as a 2 plus. Gradual release from the test position 3 minus. Hold test position 3, grade 3. Hold test position against slight or moderate pressure 4 minus. So basically here I just want to tell you and show you what is minus and plus. यहाँ पे, so moving to the next slide, this is also telling the plus and minus values, how you have to grade it, but most importantly you should know 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 0 grade, that is more important. Plus minus is very much precision is required, that will come by practice. So principles of the manual muscle testing: position, stabilization, demonstration, applications of grade, application of resistance, checking normal strength, objectivity and documentation. These are the principles of MMT which should you consider when you practice, when you use it on a patient. Everything is important and you should take all points in consideration when you are doing MMT. So let's talk about the position of the patient. Patient is positioned eliminated or against gravity. Patient depend upon testing on muscle or muscle group. So it is important which grade you want to check, which part of the body is affected, how you will position a patient. If you want to check grade 2, you should know what is gravity eliminated position of any muscle. You should know what is against gravity position of each and every muscle of your body. Do not change patient position repeatedly, because if you will change, his patient is not able to move very comfortably, he is not able to move or change position very easily. So if you want to check any kind of your muscle power or any other testing you want to do, just ask him to sit in a position and just carry out all the procedures you want to carry out in that particular position. So next point is, the patient should be as free as possible from discomfort or pain for the duration of each test. It may be necessary to allow some patient to move or to be positioned differently between tests. So just try to see that comfortness of the patient, and patient should be in your control, and you should counsel the patient very nicely so he can feel that you are doing a best possible things to the patient. Patient position should be carefully organized so that position changes in a test sequence are minimized, and the patient's position must permit adequate stabilization of the part or parts being tested by virtue of the body weight or with the help provided by the examiner. So you should know proper positionings and just try to minimize movements between the test and sets you want to do. Joint positions. Joint positions is also changed depend upon their performance. Distal part of the joint is moved. Place the joint in anti-gravity position for grade 3. Place the joint in horizontal position for grade 4. So here you can see that this is an example of anti-gravity position. Patient is doing a hip flexion in anti-gravity against gravity position, and this is a hip flexion grade 3. And here you can see that patient is performing hip abduction, adduction in gravity eliminated position, where gravity is not countering your movement. So you should know what is gravity against gravity and what is gravity eliminated position. So next principle is stabilization. We'll discuss this stabilization in the next class.